Does video editing scare the bejesus out of you? Or maybe you just open iMovie, put your video in there, maybe you don't know how to put your video in there, but you're just totally overwhelmed by what's going on in iMovie. I totally understand. So in today's video, I'm gonna walk you through an easy to follow iMovie tutorial so that you can simply get your videos edited and uploaded to YouTube. Hi, my name is Trena and welcome to my channel, Tips with Trena. Here on this channel, I help creative business owners like you get on YouTube to grow your business. So if you're interested on how to use video here on YouTube to grow your business, make sure you click that subscribe button. And we're gonna jump right into the iMovie tutorial. So I'm gonna go over to my computer to show you step by step how to edit your next video.
Okay, so I have iMovie open and what I'm gonna do is create a new movie. So the next step you wanna do after you've created a project is you wanna import your media. So what I need to do is plug in my camera card. Here you'll see all the video clips that I have from the videos that I filmed today. And I want to grab this one and I'm gonna hit Command and click this one as well because these are two different clips for the video I'm editing today. Okay, so once you have your videos imported, what you're gonna do is go ahead and drag them down here to your timeline. And then I'm gonna drag this one to my timeline. And you can make this bigger so you can get closer to the sound waves, which is gonna be important when I bring in my audio file. So what I'm gonna do is go Command plus, make back to the beginning here. And you'll see these are little sound waves of the audio that you're doing in that clip. So now I want to pull in the audio file. And your audio is going to be this little green guy right here. So I'm going to go ahead and drag it under this video. And I need to zoom out a little bit so I can sync the audio with the video. So you'll see I'm going to make a clap right here. And you see that peak in the sound wave? It's also happening right here in the separate audio file. I'm gonna go ahead and minimize this and match up these two peaks in audio. You can always zoom in. So now that this is synced up, you can see that when I clap, you hear the clap as well. All right, so I'm gonna go ahead and grab this little arrow right here and turn this volume down. I do not want the video audio on my movie. And so now this is gonna be the soundtrack for the video. You'll see, we'll press right here.
We are 1 month into 2018, and how are you doing with those goals and resolutions?
So now what you wanna do is go in here, click on the video file, go Command B, and that's going to cut your video file. And you're gonna do the same thing to your audio file, cut, and then you delete this past stuff, and now your video begins.
We are 1 month into 2018,
So I always like to change up my videos to keep it interesting. So I'm going to show you how I zoom in every couple of clips to keep people watching. I actually want to be zoomed in at the beginning here. So I'm going to click this video file and I'm going to go up to the square button and I'm going to do crop to fit. And I'm going to grab the crop to just zoom it in a little bit and you can decide where you want it to be. I want to be in the center. So I think that looks good and I'm gonna hit enter. Now the video is zoomed in for the beginning.
We are 1 month into 2018 and how are you doing with those goals and resolutions? Have you fallen off the...
See, now it looks like you have two different camera angles. It is zoomed in and zoomed out. So then you can just go through your editing and clip everything that you need. Every, you know, 10 or 15 seconds, you can zoom in, zoom out, and that's how you want to do that. So the next thing I want to talk about is adding audio and titles to your video. So iMovie already has some titles in here that you can click on and see what they'll look like on your video. And all you can do is grab this and put it right here. Now you double click that, you can say, what are your goals? You can change the font, make it bold. You can put it to the left. You can change the color. So that's really how you can add text. And if you go in here, you'll see what that will look like.
Have you fallen off the wagon yet? And today is...
And so you'll see, you know, that clicks over. So you have to be careful of what you pick, but there are only so many options here in iMovie. And I want to show you a little secret. I bought some transitions from this website called VFX, and they have some really cool YouTube clips. So if you have Final Cut Pro, you can check on here and see the different things that this comes with. If you click this play button, you'll see the different imagery and the text that you get. So there's over 90 titles, all these different types of titles from here. There are a bunch of different places that have things like this, even in Creative Market. So that's how I've really been adding text and upgrading my YouTube videos in Final Cut Pro. Another thing you can do is add audio. So there's a bunch of already pre-recorded audio in here that just makes your text stand out. So I may want to grab this bell sound, add it for when my text pops up. And so now this is what it sounds like.
Have you fallen off the wagon yet?
And now your voice recording file goes down to the bottom. That's okay. So you just see that it's stacked on top of each other.
Have you fallen off
Ta-da!
The wagon yet?
So the next thing you might be thinking about when it comes to editing is a transition. You know, you want it to flip or blur out or do something fancy. Don't get too fancy with these. Don't add too many. Just use them where you need them. But you'll go here to transitions, and here are all the different ones that you can use. I prefer to stay very simple. You don't want this spinning one. It's just distracting. Try something very non-discrete like this cross dissolve. So if I take this and I put it between these two clips, you'll see what this looks like.
In February. Hi, my name is Trena.
It's very discreet. Or if you don't want that one, go ahead and delete it. We can go up here and say you want to do a swipe right. Add this in here.
In February. Hi, my name is Trena and welcome to my channel.
Okay, so those are the different things you can do. Again, I would not get super fancy. Let me just show you, for example, it just looks tacky. Say you do this puzzle one.
In February. Hi, my name is Trena, and welcome.
It just doesn't look right. It looks much cleaner if you do jump cuts and very non-discreet transitions. So the next thing that I want to show you is how I take an additional clip and add it in here. So I filmed this in front of the camera, but I also have an overhead shot of my planner. So what I will do is insert that clip in between this clip right here. So here, let me show you. So I'm gonna go ahead and clip this. I'm gonna go ahead and zoom out and grab this clip that I grabbed, an additional clip. And one other thing that I wanna do, since this looks upside down, I'm gonna go up here to this guy and just flip it around. So if you are filming, you know, an overhead shot where you're planning with somebody or you're doing a DIY or a craft, you can always film it whichever way you need and then just flip it right in editing. So now I need to go back to my media. And this was the other PowerSheets audio file. So I'll drag that down in here, line it up with this clip. I'm gonna need to zoom in some. There's my clap, take that out. Line it up with this guy. One other thing I'm gonna do is make sure this video clip is highlighted. I'm gonna go to this paintbrush right here. And what this is it's just gonna brighten it up a little bit just so it stands out. And I also wanna saturate it just a little bit more so that the colors stand out. And I might make it just a little tint of blue. You can always make it big to see what it's gonna look like. And it just gave it a little more pop of color, just made it a little bit whiter. And that's just the basic editing you need to do on a video for a clip. So I'm gonna go through here and cut up all of these clips to where I mess up. And now, at the end of this clip, what it's gonna look like for you is, it looks like it's overhead, and now there I am. So you don't have to film and then switch it up and film. You can do multiple clips and pull them in and make them flow in editing.
Okay, now, do you think editing is too overwhelming, or do you think you got this? What questions do you still have that are holding you back or totally overwhelm you? Let me know down in the comments section. I'm answering all your questions. Don't forget, you can check out more videos from me by clicking that video that's on your screen right now. And if you want to continue to learn how to use YouTube to grow your business, make sure you click subscribe for weekly videos to help you grow. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.